Hi guys, my name is Vova and I'm a motion designer here at Motion Design School, and in this video I'm going to tell you how to create a model of cute stylized character in Cinema 4D on the example of this monkey. Over the course of creating the character, I will show you a bunch of little tricks and techniques I use daily, and that significantly facilitate the workflow. Let's start! I'll start with uploading the sketch of the character kindly provided by Anna Abramova into the scene. She is a very talented illustrator, so make sure you follow her and me on Instagram. I'll switch to the front view. If you are new to Cinema 4D, then click this button or the mouse wheel to switch between views. We need the front view. And now the project settings, Shift V hotkey. Select the sketch here. Great. We need to decide on the size of the character. It's a good practice to create real-sized or approximately real-sized models. So I'll create a model of human and make the character's height, let's say about 130 centimeters. Let's fit the size of the sketch to the guide. And increase the opacity of the image to help us. Done. Now I'll do the same thing for the right view. Now planning. I'll divide the creation of the model into the three stages and use a different set of tools for each stage. First, I'll show you how to easily and quickly create the character's body and head. I'll then get down to the limbs and the tail. At the third stage, I'll create all the character's minor details, such as the ears, face, and the spot on its belly. In short, let's get started. To create these smooth shapes, I'm going to need a cube and a subdivision surface. I will make the cube editable straight away by clicking this button. If you pack the cube into the subdivision, it becomes a sphere. And now we can adjust its shapes by creating additional edge loops. You can find the loop cut tool here, or you can as well press M and L successively to activate it. And now, if we'll create an edge loop in this area of the cube, it will be more detailed, because there will be more edges. The areas with fewer edges will look smoother. Let's create a cube like this and make it editable. I will also add a few edge loops to it. Next, I need to add a subdivision surface. When you select the cube and click this icon, holding down Alt, the cube gets added to the subdivision. It's a very useful hotkey. Let me now match the shape of the object to fit the sketch with rectangle selection and scale. I also recommend that you enable the grid of the model for convenience. Okay, I have a more or less matched shape in the sketch. Let's now check what the object looks like when to switch in another view. Let me make a few changes. Please note that I am scaling the loop only on one of the axes, rather than on all of them. That's because I don't want to spoil the shape I've created in the previous view. So the basis shape of the head is ready. I propose that we create the character's body in the same way. Let's now get to create the limbs. To begin this, I'll create a null and I'll move it at the base of the foot. My course of action is to create a few null objects for the bases of the foot, the knee and the thigh. Then, using tracer, I will create a spline that passes through these null objects. I will also need to create a cube with a few edge loops and subdivision. It will be foot itself. The last step will be to connect the cube with the tracer using spline wrap. This way I'll get an easy and adjustable rig of the leg with controllers. It's more than enough for this cartoonish character. Let's begin. Create three null objects and group them into the separate null. Let's now select the nulls and add a tracer. The nulls have been automatically added to the list. If you want to create a more complex rig of a leg, you can drag and drop the new nulls to this list. For now, 3 is enough. Choose the connect all object mode. Set the curve type to be spline to achieve a smooth curve. As I am dragging the null, you can see that the line isn't smooth and the knee is sharp. That's because I need to also set the interpolation mode of the internal points. Choose adaptive, because it renders more points on the curved section and fewer points on straight ones. The basis is ready. I will now create the geometry of the leg itself. Group it into the null and add it to the very bottom of the leg group. This one is important. Now I just need to add spline wrap to it and place it on the same hierarchy level as the leg geometry. Right here. I'll set the tracer here. Done. As you can see, the geometry follows the nulls. I'll duplicate this group to get the second leg. I will also change how the controllers look to make them more visible and easier to select, like this. And I'll make the geometry itself semi-transparent here. And lastly, I will hide spline wrap in the viewport. That's it. I will similarly create the character's arms. I'll duplicate one of the legs. The arms will be larger than the legs and slightly more complex in shape. That's why I'll add another null to it. I'll duplicate this one and add it to the tracer here. I'll arrange them approximately like this. Now I need to create a smooth thickening and narrowing of the arm. I'll do this here inside spline wrap in the size tab. Note that this option allows you only to reduce the shape, so I recommend that you use scale to make the geometry of the limb thicker than it should be. I'll select the cube and scale it up on the all axis, so that is as wide as the width of the largest part of the arm. And now let's spend a few happy moments adjusting the size graph and the positioning of the controllers. Done. I'll duplicate this arm and make the second one. Now I will similarly create the tail. I'll speed the video up, not to repeat myself in the third time. The only difference is that I've added another controller and a little more edge loops to the geometry to make the model smoother. Well, this is about it. I'll now attach the tail to the rest of the monkey. The face and the minor details can be created in several ways, for instance, using textures or creating them as separate geometries. I'll show you the second way, using the shrink wrap modifier. It allows you to project one geometry onto the surface of another. Let me show you how it works on the example of this spot on monkey belly. I'll create a polygon and set this orientation like this. For convenience, I will hide everything in the viewport apart from the character's body and the new polygon. Let's adjust its size approximately like this. I'll use the subdivision surface modifier to round off the corners. I'll make the polygon editable to be able to add new edges to it, and I'll add an edge here. If you hold down Shift, you can place the edge exactly in the middle. I'm a little closer to the shape I need. Let's adjust the shape in the point mode so that it matches the sketch. Like so. And I'll add another loop here in the middle to round it off more precisely. Now I need to project this geometry onto the surface of the body. So that I'll group the subdivision into a null, and now I'll add the shrink wrap modifier to it. As a target object, I'll set the object I want to project onto. And now we can see that the geometry is exactly matched with the surface. Now I can extrude this part forward to get rid of the intersection with the geometry of the body and also to create a smooth edge of the spot. To achieve that, I'll use the closed surface generator, in which I'll increase the thickness. And now I'll add another subdivision surface to it. Note that the smoothness of the geometry directly depends on the object onto which is projected. So, if you have noticed some angularities or that the highlight is not smooth enough, then increase the number of subdivisions on the character's body. I will similarly create the character's face. The approach here is the same, so I'll jam to create the character's ears. I'll also create them from a cube, adjusting it like this. Now I can pack it into the subdivision. And symmetrically place the ears on the head. There you go, the model is ready. Now it's up to you to pose, color and animate it. Click the like button if you like the video. We are planning to create more free tutorials on 3D modeling, design and animation, and your suggestions will be very helpful. And if you are dying to throw yourself into the 3D, there are plenty of courses on 3D rigging and animation on our website. They will help you become a pro, even if you just got interested in this topic. Follow the link in the description. And see you next time!